enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Vai se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein!
Vá se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
I didn't want to think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all.
Toma de bala no filho da puta!
that was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them. They'd been making a reality show starring Sao Paulo's favorite housewife. Probably thought it would grease the wheels with the ransom money, but it only made me want to shove the cash down their throats. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise. I could hear drilling through the wall. It sounded more like boat hull than bone, but I needed to be sure.
Porra! Cala a boca! Ninguém pode te ouvir, caralho! Sua burguesinha, safada! Vou te pegar, é? Vou te pegar antes que eu boto uma bala na tua cabeça.
There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play. But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did. Serrano had taken Fabiana through the garage door. I had to find a way to open it. I was in a cocaine factory, but I'd stick to the depressants. It seemed Serrano's boys had targeted the entire Bronco family and didn't give a shit which one they pinched.